Now both sides have got named quite a few substitutes today, so we do expect quite a few changes for the second half in particular, sometimes a lot all at one time. Now Malaga, of course, are from the southern Spanish state of Andalusia, which is on the Mediterranean Sea. They're currently playing in La Liga. They've been in La Liga since 2008 this time, and their highest ever finished in the La Liga is fourth, where they finished in 2011-2012. Last season they finished a respectable eighth place. The club were bought out in 2011 by Qatari investor Sheikh Abdullah Ben Nasser Al Thani, and then went on a big spending spree. The following season, because of their fourth place qualifying, they managed to qualify for the Champions League, got all the way through to the quarter-final stage where they played Borussia Dortmund over two legs. Going into stoppage time in the second leg, they were leading 2-1 on aggregate when Borussia Dortmund scored two very controversial goals, to say the least. Dortmund then went on to the final where they lost to Bayern Munich. The following season, Malaga were banned by UEFA from all UEFA competitions for 4 years, which was reduced to a year because of their overspending and falling foul of financial fair play. As Malaga kick off, they're kicking from left to right on your screens. Of course, these games are all about preparation for the competitive season to come, so they're not always played at the highest tempo, as a quite vigorous challenge comes in there. Fortuna Dusseldorf win the ball back through Marcel Sobotka. Ball played out to Bebu. Okay, I'll move it away. A couple of technical problems there, so hopefully we'll be able to get back with the commentary now. Some good work from number six, some risky work there from the very tall Kevin Akpoguma, number six, at the heart of the Fortuna Düsseldorf defence. Thrown on the right-hand side, or the left-hand side rather, for Düsseldorf. It's going to be taken by Lucas Schmidt. Played into Sobotka. What do you think? This time Akpoguma comes out with the ball, but decides to turn around and play it back to his goalkeeper, Michael Rensing. Pitch is in perfect condition. There was a veterans match played on it about 2 hours ago. It was only 20 minutes each way. Two former teams from Düsseldorf to a small crowd, but today, as I say, the capacity is now 7,200. I'd estimate there's probably about 5,000 people in the ground. The main stand is completely full, as we can cameras pan in on Friedhelm Funkel, who's managed Fortuna Düsseldorf since March 2014. Julian Schwarte clears his lines. It's picked up by Malaga though. Fink with the header. Axel Bellinghausen. Okay, works the ball well for left end. 15, Lucas Schmidt can keep it in, he does very well. Damage to play in as a cross, but it's back this time to Christian Gartner. Alexander Madlin. Long cross for a ball to the right hand side. That's an excellent ball. Let's see what the first touch is like. Excellent first touch. There's Bebu, tries to get the ball in. First chance of the game there. Good cross in. Oliver Fink at the near post tries to glance it past the keeper, but just wide of the near post. But some excellent work there for Fortuna Düsseldorf, when Christian Gartner got down the right-hand side, put this perfect ball in for Oliver Fink, but he couldn't quite just get it on target. So, opportunity, with less than 4 minutes gone for the German team from the Bundesliga second division to take the lead against the more illustrious, currently, La Liga first division team from Spain. Juan Carr, number seven, playing left back for Malaga. Long ball forward for Kecko, the blonde-haired number 19. Great ball into the six-yard box. It was attacked by Sandro Ramirez, but it was just ahead of him, and it's gone harmlessly across the whole box, and it's now being brought out by Akpoguma as Marco Renzin kicks long. Slight coming together there. Emmanuel Ioka, the young 18-year-old, number 20, playing up top for Fortuna Düsseldorf. Looked like he'd been jumped on by Bakary Kone, and the referee awarded the free kick, which was threaded out to the left-hand side. That's Madlum. Akpoguma. Schirate. This time he's trying to release Ioka. Ioka does well to keep the ball in. Gets in front of Kone. Christian Gartner, left foot, cross field. Nice cushion header in, but it's just behind his teammate, and it's cleared by Llorente. So Malaga build through Bakary Kone. Burkina Faso, number two, 28-year-old, has been playing most of his career in the French divisions and was signed just this month from Olympique Lyonnais. He plays the ball out to the left-hand side. The intended target, Miguel Torres, but it doesn't find him, and it's a throw-in to Malaga. Good header by Ramirez back to his play, but again it's lost. Very well there to find Oliver Fink. Madlum. So patient build off from both sides, in particular Düsseldorf were moving across the back four and then trying to find players, but that pass didn't quite connect into 1P and all. Rosales, the right fullback, who's pushed a long way forward. Camacho, one of the holding midfield players, has come for the ball. Joined by Recchio. Recchio's just brought to the ground there by the over-enthusiastic Emmanuel Ioka. So Malaga through Rosales. Just too long. Best placement is gone. Out for an easy goal kick for Fortuna Düsseldorf. Poguma. Kevin Akpoguma hasn't got any international recognition so far. He's born in Germany through Nigerian parents, so until one of the national teams choose him for their full international squad and play him, he's eligible to play for both teams. It's a case with quite a few of the players here. Those of you that are familiar with football in Germany will know that so many of the players' parents have made their way to Germany for refuge or for work over the last 50 years. And as it's been heavily publicised over the last year, many Syrian immigrants have made their way over as well. But in the past, it's predominantly Turkish people who've been holding jobs down now for 30, 40 years, and their children born here. They have a choice of playing either for Germany, the land of their birth, or for Turkey. Some, like Mesut Özil, chooses to play for Germany. Other people, like Arda Turan and Nuri Sahin, chosen Turkey. So a lot of these players today are still eligible for both sides, as Malaga through Rosales. Left foot into Sandro Ramirez. Ramirez was signed just a couple of weeks ago from Barcelona, the 21-year-old centre forward. Kone, long cross-field ball, trying to find Keko. Swept up nicely that time by Bellinghausen, but the long ball from Madlung is far too far beyond Ioka and Diego Llorente, number 20, who's currently on a one-year loan from Real Madrid. The 22-year-old centre-back plays it to his fellow centre-back. Ramirez loses control there, number 8, puts his hand up to acknowledge that. And Schwarte back to his goalkeeper. It's a hopeful ball down the middle for Bellinghausen to chase, but it's easily cut out. Some nice work there by Malaga, Recio and Torres, but I can't quite find the advancing Anor, number 10. Madlen, right across the field to Poguma. Ball played first time by Ioka out to Elas Bebu. And the crowd applaud a very good crossfield pass again. And they build on the left-hand side through the German Lucas Schmidt. Great cross into the area. Oh, looked like there was a little push there. Fortuna Düsseldorf back in possession. Elas Bebu going for the ball. Volleyed gently away there by cushion volley by Camacho to his fullback, and it's a throw into Malaga. It'll be interesting to see the replay of that, because either there was a little push in the back or the Düsseldorf forward was very theatrical in the way he went to ground. Throw into Anor, he's challenged quite firmly in the back by Madlum. Referee very well positioned. Gives the free kick to Malaga, 15 yards inside their own half. It's swept out to Llorente. Keko suggesting he wants the ball. Anor's in a good position. Camacho, Ignacio Camacho, has played once for Spain. Comes and gets the ball. Anor tries to play a 1-2 with Ramirez, but the ball doesn't find its intended target on the way back. It's played back to goalkeeper Michael Renzing. Big jump from Bakary Kone, launches the ball forward again, picked up by his opposite centre-half, Kevin Akpoguma. And Renzing kicks it out to the left flank. Keiko's trying to close down Schmidt very quickly down. He's done so the second time. This forces Schmidt to play it back to his goalkeeper. Well, we're 12 minutes into the game now. Nothing really tested either of the goalkeepers. It was a good left put the ball in recently from Schmidt, which the intended target went to ground. Here we've got a chance, it's just broken offside trap. Ioka, can he beat the goalkeeper? Some great goalkeeping there from Carlos Camini. He was very quickly off his line there as Ioka hits it low to the goalkeeper's right, but a goalkeeper comes off his line and blocks the shot. Some very good goalkeeping. As Düsseldorf have them penned in. Bellinghausen. One P Anor has to race back to help cover his defenders there, and it's the first corner of the game. Here we see the replay. Goalkeeper made a very good save there. He came flying off his line. Some good control initially by Ioka, but perhaps needed to get the ball away just a little bit earlier. But his left foot shot was on target, and low to the goalkeeper's right, but the goalkeeper made an excellent block. So the corner's going to be swung in right-footed. It's played short. Schmidt, this time it's curled into the far post. Just hit too hard there. Intention was good. There were five Düsseldorf players in the box waiting for that. But the delivery from Christian Gartner, who took the initial corner, wasn't great. And it just goal kick for Malaga. That's a poor goal kick, and this could be the first goal of the game. Another great save. The goalkeeper redeemed himself there, Carlos Camini, with a very casual goal kick, which I think went straight to Oliver Fink. I think it was Oliver Fink. It might have been Axel Bellinghausen. He played it into the box. And the sharp shot was brilliantly saved, one-handed, to the goalkeeper's right by Camini. Got his team out of jail there, having put them in that difficult position seconds before. Another in-swinging corner played to the near post. Good header, headed back again. And Camini reaches out and catches the ball before a third Düsseldorf player can get to it. So the side from the German Bundesliga 2 have made quite a bright start. We're less than 15 minutes into it, and the goalkeeper has had to make two brilliant saves to stop the team going from behind. Yes, that's a really poor ball by Kony. He hits himself in frustration and he knows what he did. Long throwing down the line. Oliver Fink is going for the ball. High clearance bounces into no man's land on the halfway line. No Malaga players near it, so gives Lucas Schmidt time to play into Gartner. Back with Madlen. Gartner. He's just trying to pull the Malaga players out of position. As Anor comes to close down. Good ball over down the right-hand flank this time. Can't get across him. Chance is first goal of the game. Oh no, it's hit the side netting from this angle. It looked like it had gone in. That was a really good chance there. Just need to see the replay to confirm who was responsible there. I think it might have been Axel Bellinghausen, but they worked the move very well down the right hand side. As we see Schwarte get forward, little toe poke by Yoga. Ends up with Bellinghausen, left-footed, hits it very firmly, but just 6 inches to the outside of the goalpost. So three good chances now for Düsseldorf, to the frustration of the home fans here. Paul Jung Stadion in Düsseldorf. Experienced international player for Venezuela, has played 66 times for Venezuela, and signed from FC 20 in Holland in July 2 years ago. Camacho did very well to hold on to the ball there, finds Enor, back to Camacho. Keke is a 1-2 with Rosales. Gets the ball back, tries to put it through the legs of Schmidt, but was unlucky there. Through two players, just hoofed clear in the end, but that was the right tactic. Carlos Camini in goal in his bright orange strip. Number one, has played 73 times for his Cameroon. Ball through the legs of Debu. Pulled back, could be a chance here. Shot coming in from number 18 across the goal. Oh, I thought it was going to be deflected in there by Ramirez. Initial shot from Rosales, and it results in eventually in a goal kick. So that's a good break by Malaga. On the left-hand side, I think it was Miguel Torres, or it might have been Johnny, got past Debu, who had come back to cover, and managed to get a cross in, which everybody missed, and then it eventually came out to Rosales, whose shot was blocked, and then had the goal kick. The halfway line. Two players jump for it. It's won by the Düsseldorf player, number seven, Oliver Fink. Keke. It's just caught from behind by Christian Gartner. Nothing malicious there. wasn't the worst ball. It was intended to get behind the fullback there for Johnny to run onto. The ball hit by Camacho, but just a little bit too much pace on it, and easy for Michael Rensing to gather. He's not being pressed by the Malaga forward, so he's got time to try and pick his spot. But when you hit it 50, 60 yards like that, it's in balance who's going to win it. But it's picked up by Dusseldorf temporarily. But Bebu can't hold on to it, and Malaga have it. Nice work from Bellinghausen that time. Half turn with his left foot, drags the ball away, finds Lucas Schmidt. Gartner, back to Schmidt. He's under pressure now. This is a real break for Malaga. This could be a real good goal scoring opportunity as Anor comes in. As Ramirez on the far post just needs to put it in, and it's 1-0 to Malaga. Well, that was the mistake, I think, by Schmidt on the left hand side, which presented Malaga with a break. They had two players running at the goalkeeper, one on the right hand side as the defenders came across to cover him. Ramirez, number eight, Sandro Ramirez, took up an excellent position 12 yards out, adjacent to the far post, and all he had to do was just pick his spot, and right-footed puts it past Michael Rensing for the first goal of the game. As we see the replay, Anor breaks on the left-hand side, and there's the shot into the roof of the net. As soon as the possession was lost there, Schmidt was trying to get forward on the left-hand side, and he tried to take on Keko, but Keko managed to win the ball and get clear. I mean, not Anor, Juan P. Anor, number 10, got clear on the right-hand side, and by the time the defence had turned, Ramirez was 15 yards ahead of them, not in an offside position. And Anor very unselfishly played the ball back perfectly to him. And like all good centre-forwards, the 21-year-old former Barcelona player puts his side 1-0 up. So 20 minutes gone. Right to Madlon. Madlon's going to be closed down. Back to Paguma. The crowd are quite quiet at the moment. They're probably a little bit disappointed to have gone a goal behind. But after a bright start where they created three decent goal scoring opportunities, the last 10 minutes, really, they've just been passing it around the back or trying to get through and having their passes blocked. Madlong. Juan Carr, number seven, manages to get to the ball first there. Now jumps Christian Gartner. Just a little bang to the head there, but he's playing on. He didn't make a meal of that, which was good. So throw into Dusseldorf, 15 yards inside the Malaga half on the right hand side. The throw in. Some good work there by Yoki, tries to drag the ball back and forces Malaga to give another throw in away. And the player's probably 5 yards ahead of where the ball went out, so the referee's making it take it from the correct spot. He needs some movement. That time it's a Yarka. Debu. High. Hopeful ball to the far post. It's missed there by Rosales, and it's a chance. Oh, and it's another. Oh, it's a goal. It's an equaliser. Well, a bit of a comedy of errors there. Roberto Rosales goes for the high swung in ball to the far post. Completely misjudges it. The ball goes over his head. It's picked up. I think that was by Bellinghausen. He attempts a shot which is going wide. And luckily, Oliver Fink, number seven, was on hand to put it into the net as we wait for the replay. Actually, it's Lucas Schmidt, crossed to Bellinghausen, snatches at the shot, being very disappointing. Big groans from the crowd as Bellinghausen's shot is certainly going wide here. But Oliver Fink read it very well, came in at the far post, just ahead of Bakary Kone, and the equalising goal within 5 minutes of going behind. So, Oliver Fink, 34-year-old German. That's got the crowd going. Rosales. Keko. Nice little flick there from Rosales. Camacho's got further forward than he has for the rest of the game. Anor. Good ball into Recchio. Everyone but the goalkeeper, Kamini, inside the Düsseldorf half. Wankar gets the ball to Johnny. Johnny's trying to get a corner there, but the ball's out of play before he can get his foot onto the ball there. So, well, we've had some excitement in the last 15 minutes after a slow start. Three good chances not taken by Fortuna Düsseldorf. Malaga take over the game, get a goal, a little bit about against the run of play, then sort of dominate for a few minutes, and then we get this equaliser that really came out of nothing. So probably one always a fair scoreline. Michael Rensing launches it long. Flicked on header from goalscorer Fink. Iyoki tries to close down Coney, but it's played back to his goalkeeper, Carlos Kamini, who plays it out to Roberto Rosales, and a lot of space on the right. It's noticeable that Düsseldorf aren't closing down Malaga either, pressing the defence, so they're not being forced to make any hasty passes here. Camacho, who's principal holding midfield players, comes back to gather the ball. Kone into Johnny, loses possession, plays it straight to a Düsseldorf player, Schwarte. Tries to find Iyoka, but it's swept up by Bakary Kone, and it's back to the goalkeeper. Recchio. Oh, excellent ball through that Anor, and Ramirez now is in a position to get a shot away. He feeds it back to Anor. There's a chance on the left-hand side. Johnny's crossed the left-hand side. Palmed out by the goalkeeper, straight to one of the forwards. Düsseldorf a bit lucky to get away with that, to be honest. Some good work from Malaga. And a good cross comes in from Johnny. I'm not quite sure who the snapshot was from there. I think it might have been Recchio. But it was sort of presented to him almost on a plate by the goalkeeper there. I know it's really difficult when you're diving out like that, but you can't be palming it back into the path of potential attackers. And the shot, when it came back in from Recchio, luckily drifted wide of his left-hand post, so we still have parity at 1-1. Bellinghausen brings it down his chest, back with his right foot. Schmidt heads it on to Gartner, Madlungen. And we've got a run over the top by Bebu. He's got the pace, but I think Kamini, who had been in a sweeper position only about 4 yards from the edge of his penalty area, was able to get across just before the swiftly moving Elas Bebu, as Malaga break on the left-hand side. The referee gives a free kick as Wankar runs to the edge of the area and collides that time with Schwarte. The home fans don't think it was a free kick. It looked like obstruction from here, but I'm probably 60, 70 metres away. But the referee was very well positioned as the sole arbiter, and he's decided it's a free kick, and this is in a very dangerous position for Malaga. On the edge of the area, about 20 yards from goal. Referee spotted the ball. He's now moving the two-man wall back the 10 yards. Well, we have seen players score goals from this position, but it would need to probably be from a right-footed player, and it's going to be 1P Anor, left-footed, as there's five players in the box, headed clear by one of the Fortuna Düsseldorf players, but it's going to be a throw-in on the right-hand side, very near the corner flag. Salis makes his way right up the touchline. Throwing back to Llorente, everybody by goalkeeper Kamini inside the Düsseldorf half, as Kone brings it forward. Out to Johnny on the left-hand side. Three players make a run to the penalty area: Ramirez, Anor, and Keko. But Johnny gives the ball away, but then gets it back off Schwarte. What can he do here? He's pinned in the corner. Just caught by Schwarte, but Schwarte also gets the ball, so they play on. And we've got a slight chance for a break here for Düsseldorf. Iyoka puts it one side of Kone, tries to go around him, and Iyoka gets it back again. No one up with him, unfortunately. Bellinghausen and Fink both making their way to the area now, but they needed to be 10 yards faster, and he could have played a side-footed crossfield ball, but there was no one there. It's been forced back. They could even lose possession here as Bebu gets caught by a rather over-enthusiastic challenge there from Sandro Ramirez. So Bebu did well to get down the right-hand side. He showed the ball to Kone, and Kone looked like he had it under control, but all of a sudden Bebu had nicked it back off him and there was a way, but he was looking up for players to pass to, no one there, so nothing came of it. Find Ramirez. Rensing hits it first time, hits Keko and drops to the feet of a Malaga player, but then bounces for Ioka. He finds Bellinghausen on the left, being closed down by Keko, who has to play it back to Schmidt. Gartner, the Austrian in space, plays it out to Schwarty on the right hand side, just a little bit too high for him. Schwarty did his best to keep it on with his head, but you don't have much chance when you're that close to the touchline, especially when there's some wind around, and there is quite a bit of wind in the stadium here in Düsseldorf. Camacho. Gets it back from Rosales, tries to get over the top for Ramirez. There's a chance here he can get out of control, but the linesman's flag goes up. Some good work from Ramirez there. The only thing he failed to do was just stay onside for quite long enough. His first touch was excellent. It was a really good ball from Camacho that found goal side of defender Medlum, brought it down with his right foot. Really good, nice controlled volley to bring it off. Controlled it. I don't know if our viewers can hear the wind that's whistling around the stadium here. We're up on a very exposed gantry, weaverable gantry, probably 40 foot off the ground, and the wind is really whipping around here. Doing my best to stop my notes flying everywhere. In the meantime, you may get a bit of wind noise through the microphone. I have to say, there's some rather ugly looking clouds coming in our direction. That's going to be all right for a lot of the supporters in the main tribune because they're undercover. The ones that aren't might get a little bit wet. Footballers won't mind it. It's always nice to have a bit of rain in the summer when you're playing football. Softens the pitch up a little bit, makes it easier to slide in, cools you down. But from the position I am, we're in an uncovered gantry with two cameramen. I really hope it doesn't start raining. Some nice work on the left-hand side by Malaga, but the ball's intercepted by Fink, and he's away to Ioka. To Gartner. Oh, it's a shame. He just overhit that ball. Schmidt got into position. Ioka was caught late there, and I think the referee's going back. He had initially played advantage, and I think he's going to go back and give a free kick to Dortmund, very close to the halfway line. He just gets caught by his opposite number 20, Diego Llorente. I don't think there's anything malicious there, but here's a free kick. A very big physical specimen that Emmanuel Ioka is. He must be all of 6'4" and probably 14 stone. Looks more like a cruiserweight boxer than some footballers, but he should have the strength to hold off quite a few challenges. He's already shown his pace. As Akpoguma hits it long to the left-hand side, Schmidt intelligently volleys it first time into the area, to the edge of the D. There was the run from Fink, but it was cleared by Malaga through to Sandro Ramirez, who came across the left. A very good challenge there from Schwarte, tracked him all the way across. No, it was Sobotka, sorry, it was Sobotka, got across to him and foiled the run from the Malagaese player. Short this time. A bit lucky there, the ball bounces off of Fink and comes back to him as Bellinghausen goes forward. He collided with Rosales. I don't think there was any intent from Rosales, and the referee said he judged it to be an innocent challenge. As Bellinghausen looks like he tries to get it back, there's a few jeers from the crowd on both sides as players are going in. Just looked a little bit ugly for about 10 or 15 seconds there. I think the Fortuna Düsseldorf player felt aggrieved and then tried to get a little bit of revenge, not with anything nasty, but that provoked another foul from Malaga and then another foul from Düsseldorf, and the referee finally had enough of it, awarded a free kick to Malaga. Diego Llorente looks to play into Keko, changes his mind, and it's off to Kone. This ball's poor. It looked like a handball by Johnny, but he gets away on the left-hand side. He's getting tracked back by Bebu.
Well, Bebu doing really well there. He was at least 5 or 6 yards behind Johnny when he was away with the ball.
He made the pace up, got the ball, turned him, took the ball, and but unfortunately lost possession as the ball cannons off his shin. So, once again, everybody by the goalkeeper now in the Dusseldorf half with Diego Llorente. One car, number seven. He's on a two-year loan from Braga, the Portuguese. Keko. Oh, that's good work. He gets outside Schmidt in a very tight situation. Can he get a cross in? Ramirez is in the six-yard box. Oh, he tries a little flick. That really was well worked by Keko down the right-hand side. Good run from Ramirez into the box, and Johnny was accompanying him, and he tried the little flick from the ball behind his front leg. But he didn't get enough foot on it, and it just went across the goal. Some of Malaga players caught right in front of the referee, but the referee says play on. Malaga looked more interested and stopped. They're trying to make the decision for the referee. He's still saying the same. The ball's kicked out. Allow the player to get treatment. I'm not quite sure if that's Johnny or Miguel Torres that got caught there. It is Johnny. Marcel Saboka just gives him a little pat, says, no hard feelings, I didn't mean that. As you see, the great work from Keko. A little tempted flick, just got a little bit more on that. That would have nestled in the back of the net, just to the goalkeeper's right, but didn't quite make enough contact. But a great break by Malaga. Certainly some excellent work from Keko down the right-hand side. How he got past Schmidt when he was so tight to the line and kept the ball in play there before he got into position to make the cross. I'm not sure, but he's into the ball again now, but just a little bit too long for him. Rensing does very well as he comes off his line. Bebu releases Suarti down the right-hand side. There's three players into the box, but the ball was just too far ahead of them. And again, good goalkeeping. Carlos Camini read the situation very well off his line. Gathered the ball probably 9-10 yards out as Ioka and Bellinghausen and Fink were all making runs into the box at different angles, and the ball was just probably just about 3 or 4 yards too far ahead of them. But again, a very good break. Keko. Bellinghausen tries to close him down. Llorente. Reccio. Johnny in some space on the left hand side. Had three in the box waiting for him to take the player on. He cuts inside, then he cuts outside, but Bebu gets the ball. Can he find a Dusseldorf player? He goes to ground rather clumsily, claiming he was fouled right in front of the spectators, who all felt the same. I'm not sure if the referee's given a free kick or a throw-in there, judging by the hand gesture by the referee, by number 22, Johnny, who collided there with Bebu. And he's given a free kick, and that's why he was a little bit frustrated with the referee, I guess. There's Lucas Schmidt. Back to Madlong. Schwarte. Some very good first touch there from Fink. Tries to get round. Kone turns very well, but his attempted pass down the wing goes out of play, and it's a throw in 10 or 12 yards from goal. Fortuna Düsseldorf. Schwarte to take the throw in. Bebu showing for him, as is Fink. Ioka is in the box. Decides to play to Christian Gartner. He turns and goes back to his foot. To a centre half, Madlam. Unfortunately, the pass is too long, and it's straight into the hands of goalkeeper Camini. Camacho's intended long cross for a ball was blocked initially by Ioka. Munkar tries to get to the ball. The players felt that had gone out of play. But Malaga get it back, and it's Anor. He's running at Akpoguma. Tries to find Keko, but it's well read by Schmidt. And it's Bebu, number 37. Looks out to his right. Out to his right is Oliver Fink. Gartner. Nice
nice work there from Akpabuma to Fink. Again, Ioka just timed his run incorrectly. That was good work. He lost the centre half. As the young assistant referee, he was in an excellent position. Flags for the offside. He was got about 3 yards offside by the time the ball was played. So it was the right idea, but you've got to just learn to time those runs. And that takes, I guess, years of experience. And Emmanuel Ioka is only still at just 18 years of age. Lorente trying to find Johnny with a very long ball. Intercepted there by Schwarty, who's hurt his hip. The referee gets a free kick, asked Schwarty how he is, and I think he suggested he's okay, but he felt it was a foul challenge on him. Just a little bit of words in German between our referee today and Julian Schwarty. Meanwhile, Juan Carr ready to take the throw in. On the left-hand side. Renzing out to Kevin Akpabuma. Marcel Sabota, can they keep it in? Now left fullback Lucas Schmidt did it brilliantly there. He actually chested it down. His feet were over the line, but his chest wasn't, and the assistant referee was in an excellent position. To play on. Madlam gets it long behind Rosales on the left hand side. Can Schmidt keep it in? He's done very well again. Again, he hits it first time into Bellinghausen. I think that comes off number 20. No, the referee, who is only 10 yards away. Well, there's a little coming together there between Bellinghausen and Llorente. I don't know what that is. That's what they call in England handbags. Out of nothing, Llorente suddenly goes towards Bellinghausen and sort of chest to chest like a couple of gorillas. Facing off, referee quickly calms the situation and he calls the players over. Llorente, I don't know if he will speak any German. I suspect English will be the international language. There we go. Oh, it's a little tap on the head from Bellinghausen. That was a bit unsporting, really. And you can see why Llorente slightly overreacted. But the referee's calmed the situation now. And the referee's now telling Bellinghausen that that's not a good idea. So just wait for the corner to be taken in the 42nd minute. It's going to be swinging on the right-hand side. Meanwhile, Dusseldorf have 5 players in the box, 1 on the line. Thing. 4 more players waiting just outside. Right foot in swinger to the penalty spot. We're cleared off the line by Kecko. Well, they did well to win the header there, the Düsseldorf players. And snap header. Oh, keeper's lost that. Presented the Ioka of a half chance. Might be another corner. A lot happening here. Referee's pretty angry with one of the Malaga players. I can't quite see from this angle who that is, but he's just been talking very animatedly towards Reggio, number 14. Maybe there's a couple of things happening off the ball that we just can't keep our eyes on. As we see the replay of the cross as it comes in, bounces in front of the goalkeeper, comes off his chest, gives Ioka a chance to toe poke, but it's closed down very quickly and it's such a tight angle, but he does manage to get the corner, which is going to be taken left-footed by Bellinghausen. Indicates that they're going to do something. They've worked on the training field just outside the 6-yard box. About 10 players went from that from both sides, but it's Ioka on the left hand side. Can he get across him with his left foot? Blocked by number 18, Rosales, and it's going to be a throw into Fortuna Dusseldorf. Just a couple of minutes left in this first half. It's been quite an entertaining half. Action at both ends of the field. Schmidt. Tries to find Fink, but the throw-in was cleared Oliver Fink by about 6 feet and bounces once into the hands of Comini. So Malaga now down the right-hand side with Rosales. First touch. Oh, Keiko is a bit cheeky as he tries to play it back to Rosales. He had a lot of ground to make up, and it was easily picked up by Schmidt, who's going to volley it with his left foot, that reliable left foot. It's going to be bouncing 35 yards from goal. Kone jumps. heads it back to his goalkeeper. Some very good defending there by Coney. Read the situation well and knew exactly where his goalkeeper was. Ball's bouncing that high, not easy to control. And he got just the perfect cushion header back to his goalkeeper to relieve the danger as Johnny gets it on the left-hand side. His first touch is poor and the ball runs away from him and it's picked up this time by Ayoka into Bellinghausen. Closed down quickly by two Malaga players. Sabota, Fink, Bellinghausen. This is good from Dusseldorf. Shigata comes short to support his centre defenders. Tries to draw the Malaga players out of position. Back to Gartner. And Paguna. Gartner. Well, we've got 30 seconds left in the half if there's no stoppage time added. And I'm not sure if the Dusseldorf players are aware of the clock, but there certainly seem to be in no hurry to get the ball forward, as they're playing little 1-2s amongst themselves in their own half. No Malaga players coming anywhere near them. Closest player to the action at the moment is Anor, and he was 15 yards. Ramirez has made an appearance in the Fortuna Dusseldorf half as the ball's played back to the half-time whistle. So here at the Paul James Stadium in Dusseldorf, we have a half-time score of Fortuna Dusseldorf 1, Malaga Club Football 1. As you see on the graphic, Sandro Ramirez put the Spanish La Liga operation one goal into the lead in the 20th minute, but Fortuna Dusseldorf fought back very, very well and were back on level terms within 3 minutes. So as our officials, Belgian 21-year-old Maiki Ngomba, that's number 22. So those are the two substitutes I know of at the moment. It looks to me like Malaga have stayed with the side that they started the first half with, but they do have 18 substitutes with them, so there could be quite a change in the next 45 minutes. I'll do my best to keep you informed as we wait for our referee, Christian Bandersky, to restart the proceedings. For the second half, of course, Fortuna Dusseldorf will be kicking off. We'll be kicking from left to right on your screens in their change of strip. They're playing in all white as opposed to their normal red and white colours. Meanwhile, Malaga have also got a change of colours. They're playing in the amber and black. Referee gets the game underway, exactly 5 o'clock local time. Kevin Akpaguma across to Alexander Medlin. And all trying to close him down. It's back to Renzing. We saw a lot of that in the first half. The centre halves passing to each other, maybe including the fullbacks, and the ball back to Renzing. Of course, at this time of year, it's nice to win these games, but it's all about preparation for the competitive season, which will be starting in a couple of weeks for both teams. As a long ball's launched over the top for the first opportunity here for Maki Ngomba to get the ball in. He actually gets his foot around the ball, manages to get it across Diego Llorente, who blocks, and it's gone wide of the goal, but it's gone out for a corner. So still in the first minute of the second half, and it's an opportunity from the set piece for Fortuna Dusseldorf to put Malaga under pressure. I can see Christian Gartner, the 22-year-old Austrian, making his way over. He's going to be playing it right-footed by the looks of it. We currently have 6 Dusseldorf players in the box, 1 on the edge. Ball swung to the far post. Good jump from Kone, who heads it clear. And Johnny heads it a further clear, but it's a chance for Gartner to get it in again. Long ball to the far post. There's players there. Initial header forward and a good punch from Kamini. Comes off his line in front of the defender. But I think referee is blown for an infringement. And the players, again, are not exactly squaring up to each other. But they're in each other's faces, moaning about something. I mean, it's very difficult for referees these days. There's so much shirt pulling and pushing and little cheap fouls in the box. Sometimes from the attackers, sometimes from the defenders. And the referees need to have eyes in the back of their heads. They could really do with some assistance there, but current rules the way they are, they just have to do their very best. Kone to Llorente. Into Koke. Oh. Attempted interception there from Christian Gartner, slips and Fortunately goes through to one of his fellow players as Malaga initially through Camacho. Recio joins in the fray there. Keko gets the ball, quick feet there from right foot to left foot, tries to put it round the back of Madlam, but Ramirez tries to get on it, but Madlam turns well and plays it that time to Sobotka. Renting's going to be forced to kick. Chips it about 40 yards. Doesn't quite reach his target, Schwarte. And some good work by Johnny on the left-hand side, plays a 1-2. And oh, nearly gets the ball. Diego Llorente in very, very quickly, his foot slightly up, but he nicks the ball off Mike Ngombo. Bebu on the right-hand side. Kone gets across with a very good sliding challenge. So it's going to be a throw-in to Fortuna Düsseldorf, about 25 yards from the right-hand corner flag. Schwarte into Bebu. Dramatic pull by Oliver Fink there. Oh. I think Johnny was hurt there. I don't think it was an intended foul, but it's quite a physical coming together between him and one of the other players, and he looks like he got hit in the chest. Referee, he made a loud squeal in front, the referee, but the referee just feels it was making the most of that, and there's wave play on. You see the replay of him holding his midriff, like he's caught a elbow or something in the midriff, but I don't think that was the case. So another corner, third corner of the game. To be taken, third corner of the second half. It's going to be taken again by Christian Gartner, right-footed. Once again, six players in the box, making their runs. Ball not quite as deep as before. Good header. I think that was Madlam that got up there with the header. Climbed over the back, legally, I might add, of the covering defenders, and got his head to the ball, but not quite enough power to direct it past the goalkeeper. Very good jump there. He got up before Diego Llorente could get off the ground, and if he could have just steered it a little bit higher, and a little bit wider, that may have put just sort of 2-1 up, as Kone brings the ball out slowly. There's no one pressurising him out to Hoka. His ball down the left-hand side for Johnny, hits his shoulder, intercepted by Akpoguma, expense of a throw-in, so 10 yards from the goal line. Juanca makes his way up. Number seven. Recio's looking for the short throw into his feet. Nicely controlled. Back to Juanca. 22. Johnny tries to get the cross over as we're suddenly bathed in bright sunshine. It's blocked for a throw in. It's back to Recio. He switches play. Camacho. Nice little ball behind the defender. Here's Ramirez's chance to put them 2-1 ahead. Can't get enough power on that one. That's the goalkeeper's slight error there. That was a really good ball behind the defence there from, I think it was Recio to Ramirez, who made an excellent run off of Alexander Madlen, goal side of him, but couldn't get any power on the shot. He set it low to the near post. Goalkeeper Renzing comes across, but seems to fumble it and can't keep the ball in. It comes off Renzin, goes out for a corner. The assistant referee judges it to a... Renzin makes up for that with an excellent punch, one-fisted punch with his left hand there. As the cross has a high in-swung corner, Renzin comes out just outside his penalty area into a group of players and bravely jumps in there and punches it with his left foot, left hand rather. Referee having words with Johnny. First yellow card's coming out. It clearly is petulance from Johnny. I don't know what he's going on about. I think he's still moaning about the little bump he got in the midriff about 2 or 3 minutes ago. The crowd are sort of giving him some gentle abuse as well. But this is a friendly, and I know they do take it rather seriously at times, but he's really got to keep the lid on it. Otherwise, you know, the referee could be in the mind to send him off, and you know, they don't really want to be playing for any significant amount of time with 10 players, especially in a pre-season game where it's all about improving your match fitness and conditioning rather than being fatigued because you're one man down. Meanwhile, a good turn by Juanca in his left corner. Bit of head tennis going on between the teams. Flicked on that time by Ngombo. Marlon Ritter's not touched the ball since he's been on. Just gently caught, I think, by Llorente. Llorente's gesticulating with his hands that there was no foul there. Ball comes up. Llorente comes around the back, tries to toe poke it away. May have just caught him a little bit on the hip, but you know what it's like in modern football. You just have to blow on some of these players and they go down. But this is a very, very promising position for Tuna Dusseldorf. I would estimate we're about 25 yards, 26 yards from goal. Right in the centre of the goal. It's going to be a direct free kick, so it gives them a chance to use either a left or right footed player. So I'm sure there would have been some training ground moves practiced. Looks like at the moment it's going to be set up for Marlon Ritter to take right footed, as the referee is moving the wall, this five man wall that are already stepping over the line there. I don't know if the referee's aware of that, but they've already made themselves nearly a metre. Marlon Ritter hits it low, tries to deceive them again. Carlos Comini had an excellent first half in goal for Malaga. Down sharply, saved it. It was in front of him, but it's one of those ones with a bounce very quickly in front of you, could catch you out. Marlon Ritter was clearly hoping the wall would jump, which they did. He hit the ball under the wall, and Renzing was, Comini was half expecting that. So, Schuarte. Sabota. Alexander Madelon was very disappointed with that pass. He's hit it 70 yards forward straight to Comini when the nearest player would be 40 yards from the ball there. As Recchio set up the half chance there for Malaga a couple of minutes ago, number 14. Plays a nice ball out to Llorente. But his ball can't find Ramirez. And it's Debu who gets clear, plays it out to fullback Chuati, who's got forward at every opportunity. Nice ball in with his left foot. This could be a goal. Oh, that was a really good ball in, left-footed there from right fullback Julian Schwarte, number four. Two players made a run for the ball. One of them was Makey Ngombo, and the other one was Marlon Ritter. And it beat the defenders, but it bounced between both the players and dropped harmlessly for the goalkeeper. So Malaga with a chance on the left-hand side here. Sliding challenge from Schwarte, who set the last chance up and has run 100 yards back just to slide in on Johnny, and the ball goes out for a throw into Malaga about 15 yards from the corner flag, as we see Juan de Ramos, the world-famous manager. He's been a manager of Malaga only since the beginning of this month. It's the 17th managerial appointment of his very illustrious career. He's really has managed some of the big boys. As Johnny plays the ball back in a snapshot, immediately with his left foot from Juan Pia Anor, just goes into the side netting. But getting back to Juan de Ramos, 17 clubs he's managed, including Malaga for the second stint. Real Madrid he was at, Tottenham Hotspur for a couple of years. The Spurs fans will remember him. Also Sevilla, he's 61 years of age now, but he's still at the top of his game. Renzing plays it short, left-footed, out to Schwarte. Babu turns nicely, then runs into number six, Ignacio Camacho. Certainly wasn't getting out the way there, and the referee's given obstruction, which it clearly was. Quickly taken by Gartner to the left flank. Lucas Schmidt, good left football into the area. It's glanced on by one of his players back to his goalkeeper. I don't think it was an intended back pass, but Llorente had jumped very high to try and intercept the ball before it could reach a player from Dusseldorf. And the ball spun onto his goalkeeper, unfortunately, for Malaga. Paguna, Madlin, and Schwarte again. Bebu. He's been closed by Huancar, but he's gone past him. He's also gone past Camacho to loud cheers. And he's got a great ball out onto the left-hand side. Camacho will be able to get to it. Actually, it was Schmidt who's bursting down from his left fullback position, covering. Challenge comes in from Rosales, and it's a throw into Dusseldorf, but it's wasted as the ball doesn't find the intended target, which was Oliver Fink. Ramirez. So that one out centre forward, but he has excellent first touch, jumps very well as well. Ramirez, not the tallest centre forward, and is prepared to come back, pick the ball up, and start running at players. Back in his centre forward position now, but he collected the ball 30 yards in his own half to start this move off for Malaga. Kone. left-hand corner. The wind's held it up. Schmidt's under a little bit of pressure from Keiko. And Schmidt's forced to give away a throw-in. So, throw-in to Malaga on the right-hand side, adjacent to the edge of the area. Long throw into the box. Keiko almost gets to that, but it just carries on the wind a little bit, bounces once into the goalkeeper's arms. So, in the 58th minute, we still have a scoreline of Fortuna Düsseldorf 1, Malaga 1. This ball's launched long by Rensing down the right-hand side. A good run by his right-hand fullback, Schwarte. There's an overlap here from Bedu. Can he get the ball in? Good ball into the box, but it's just beyond the centre forward. Ngompo, and it's cleared by Malaga. Picked up by Madden on the halfway line. It's time to feed of Schwarte. That ball's not too long. That's a very good ball. That's a Marlon Ritter. That's a Sabota. Gartner. Think. And the ball goes out harmlessly. Long ball out for us then. And I can see there's going to be, I think, two or three more substitutions to be made by the Fortuna Düsseldorf. It might take me a little while to identify who's coming off and who's coming on. Right. Oliver Fink, I think, is going off. Christian Gartner is going off. Or he might be getting some water. It's very difficult when you're on the opposite side to the closest. Bebu has gone off, I can see that. Fink has gone off. And the other player leaving, Schwarte. Worked very hard in the first half. Malaga, in the meantime, have taken three players off. 10, 8 and 22. So that's Johnny's gone. Ramirez has gone. And Anor. As soon as I find out who the replacements are, I will let you know. Stadium announcer is making an announcement, but it's in German, which I don't fully understand, and it doesn't carry too well to this part of the ground. The second goal for Malaga. I think that might have been caught, Pablo Fornells. No, he's just congratulating the goal scorer there. Goal scorer number 18. Roberto Rosales, who got very much forward from his initial right fullback position. I'm still trying to establish who's come on the field. As the ball finds its way to Rosales, just 8 yards out, he left foot plants it past the goalkeeper. Unfortunate goal, really, but you have to take your chances when they come, as we're in the 60th minute of the game. Ngombo kicks off. Car's gone off for number 7 to be replaced by Frederico Rica. That will help this commentator. No, actually, Wankar's moved forward. Frederico Rica's come on in the left midfield position. Rica at left back and Wankar's pushed forward. So I think Torres has gone off. Miguel Torres, number 23. There's a rather heavy challenge on Recchio. I won't say it's a wretched challenge on Recchio, but it results in a foul. His clumsily challenge from behind by number 31, Marcel Sobotka, as Coney's about to take the kick. Another little tumble from one of the Malaga players as the ball's hit behind them. It's a chance here for Fortuna Düsseldorf. A great ball back. I don't think the player running in on the ball, Ngombo was expecting the ball there. Well, the very tall player chasing down the defender there for Dusseldorf is En-Nesyri. I think he's Egyptian, number 26. Looks like he's going to be playing up top now. Referee gives a little foul there. It's number two. He's just come on the field. That's Julian Koch, number two for Dusseldorf. Gets a little challenge bang on the hip, which results in a free kick to Dusseldorf. So I haven't fully got the complete lineups at the moment, but if you bear with me, I am getting there. The break on the left-hand side. Ball fed behind, the cross in. Oh, and then En-Nesyri. With just a goalkeeper to meet from 7 yards, possibly 8 yards. Hits it rather too firmly and doesn't get over the ball, and it sails way over the crossbar. That was a real missed opportunity. You don't get a better chance of that in any level of football. I think Park players would be extremely disappointed if they'd missed that one. Again, another little foot left in there on the challenges. Marcel Sabota. Ball back with Koguma. Attempted crossfield pass, but Keke should get to that. As he's just caught as he's jumping in the air. That was a little bit of a cheap shot from Lucas Schmidt. That's how players get injured. I remember seeing a game at the Emirates the season before last, where the Boucher is just in the air, off out of balance. The ball's behind one of the bylines, have gone out already, and Arnautovic, the Austrian international, catches him with an unnecessary shoulder barge. And basically, the Boucher missed a year with a fractured shoulder and dislocated shoulder, and has never really returned to the Arsenal first team. So maybe a little bit innocuous, but it can cause a lot of damage. Under the ball, tries to flick it on. He does, gets to En-Nesyri. Committed challenge from Camacho there. Some good work from Alagris. Ball to the far post, just reached by Julian Koch just as well, because Juan Carr was lining up the left foot volley, the number seven there. Nice. Ball chipped forward. A good first early throw-in. This is number nine. Yildirim, the Turkish international. Again, ball into the near post. Cleverly cleared away by Diego Llorente. That wasn't a very good ball there from Camacho. Again, a bad pass from one of the players presents Malaga with a half chance to set up an opportunity here. Recho is involved. Ball's out to Keko. That, fortunately for Dusseldorf, it was just a little bit too firm, and it's gone out for a throw-in. Well, I think I can give you the current lineup for Malaga. It's still Carlos Kameny in goal. The back four as it started the game. Frederico Rica has come on at left fullback. Camacho and Recio are still holding in midfield. Pablo Fornals is playing in a more advanced midfield position. Keko on the right, Juan Carr forward on the left, and En-Nesyri up. Julian Koch, number two, the blonde haired number two, has come on at right fullback for Schwarte. Tries to chip the ball forward. His intended target, Mikey Ngombo, but it's easily cut out by Malaga. 4 nails. This time he comes deep. Camacho over the top for En-Nesyri. He's only been on for 7 or 8 minutes, En-Nesyri. Obviously, he blasted that chance over the crossbar, but he's a very tall player, very long legs. He's already outpaced the defence 2 or 3 times. Little short ball into Recho. Nice 1-2 there, but intercepted by Mikey Ngombo. Recho's gone to ground again, a little bit dramatically, holding his face as he slowly sits up. Referee says, get up. Ngombo this time to Julian Kopp. Some nice work on the left-hand side. Anderson Lukoku, number 36, involved there, the tall left-sided player. Oh, that's a poor attempted pass by Akpoguma. It gives Malaga to counter-attack. Akpoguma did very well to get back to recover the situation. His teammates applauding him for that. Meanwhile, Bankar is still sat down. I think he got a little knock on his ankle there. He's slowly getting up, a little bit gingerly. It's going to be a throw-in to be taken by Federico Rica. Coney. It's actually quite warm now. The cloud cover has sort of broken up a little bit. Had some bright sunshine for the whole of the second half, and I would imagine the temperature here in Düsseldorf is probably about 22 degrees. Nice if you're sitting in your garden with a cold beer, but running around on the football pitch, no matter how finely tuned these athletes are, as we get another unnecessary challenge resulting in a free kick. Anderson Lukoko caught rather heavily there by Rosales. Oh. And En-Nesyri fails to move 10 yards away from the intended free kick, and so, a bit unsportingly, Madlen kicks the ball at him, hits En-Nesyri, and the referee feels it's appropriate, even though it's just a friendly match, to give a free kick. I think there's a little bit of unsporting behaviour on both sides there. Gartner back to his goalkeeper. Paguma. Long ball, easily cut out by Rica. Last 5 or 6 minutes has been pretty dull play. Both teams conceded possession very, very quickly. Rica did well to win that header. Bankar. Else gets involved, but this time he clatters into the back of Akpoguma. Nothing intended there, and he launches the ball late as an intended shot, but it's back to where the infringement occurred, and Madlen is going to restart the game. And 71 minutes in. Oh, here we go. That's an unnecessary gift of a goal to Malaga. Puts the Spanish team 3-1 ahead now. That's very disappointing. They hadn't looked under any pressure there at all, and a misunderstanding between the defence there has set up En-Nesyri. Youssef En-Nesyri, number 26. As we wait the replay of the goal, that was some poor work there. Attempted back pass, intercepted by En-Nesyri, swept it first time with his left foot. At the same time, he had Pablo Fornes coming in on the ball as well to try and attempt a shot. Goalkeeper really had no chance. He was coming off his line quite quickly, Mikhail Rensing, and he hadn't had a chance to plant his feet when the shot was hit past him. Very difficult for goalkeepers to get down in those circumstances. So, Yildirim. Wankar switches to the right flank. Looked like he was caught late there. Maybe a little bit of frustration for Dusseldorf that they're two goals behind as Marcel Sobotka catches him. So a free kick to Malaga. I think Juan de Ramos, their manager, will be quite pleased the way things are going at the moment. Gartner still on the field. Tries to close down. Recchio had the ball. Nice ball into the feet of Fornals. Turns. Attempted interception by Koch, releases Kiko. Can you get a shot away from here? The goalkeeper's way out of his goal. Goal is undefended. Some good work there, but the shot from Federico, 15, just misses the corner of the post and crossbar to extend the lead to 4-1. Certainly 4-1 would not be a fair reflection on the play. Probably one goal is the difference at the moment, but the scoreline is showing 3-1 to Malaga. Good ball back, but he just wasn't able to pick his spot. Probably picked his spot, he just wasn't able to direct the ball accurately enough in there, and he's giving the thumbs up to his team to sort of say sorry about that. Meanwhile, En-Nesyri's gone down. I didn't see the challenge that has hurt him, but he's holding his right knee. There, Kiesvetter, Jerome Kiesvetter, the United States American player, signed from Stuttgart in June this year, 23-year-old. Cannons off of Kone for a corner, so this is a chance possibly for Fortuna Düsseldorf to pull one back. It's going to be taken by Christian Gartner, number 21. He's taken all the set-piece corners so far, and a couple of free kicks, right-footed. Seven players now in the box from Düsseldorf. Little bit of pushing going on. It's dropped kindly for Düsseldorf, but one player tries to set up Kaguma, and he can't get the shot away, so it's now back with Luca Corey as Koch inside, but again, a poor pass. So Kevin Kaguma's out of position. Gartner cleans up, but that's a poor pass. So Keke, some groans from the crowd, some poor play from both sides, actually. Now it's Fornals into a En-Nesyri, looks like he's recovered from the little knock. 26, Youssef En-Nesyri. Throwing to be taken by Anderson Lukokui. Not easy to say that one. Keko hits it against Lukokui. It's going to be another substitution. Christian Gartner, who's worked very hard in the middle of the midfield. Just waiting to see who's replaced him. To Rika. The substitute is Taylor Duman. He's a German. Turkish parents, still only 19 years of age, so he has the decision if he gets offered full international honours, which country to play for. So Good work there from Makin Ngombo. Julian Cock there. Certainly pushing players forward there. Fortuna Düsseldorf, as someone in the crowd singing happy birthday rather loudly. First touch of the ball for Taylor Duman, the 19-year-old. Manager Friedhelm Funkel. Not frightened to blood the young players for some of these friendlies. Long ball again. Left hand corner is going to be seen out of play by Rosales. As Lukoki makes a late decision to go for the ball. Well, it's very quiet around here. The Stall supporters very pleased with their first half performance. Certainly created some chances in the first half. Haven't had really much to show for the second half. A couple of half chances. And I think they've been punished by some clinical finishing from probably the more experienced Spanish team. We've just replaced Juan Carr, number 7. Just waiting to see who's come on. Just give me a moment, please. As we pan in on Juan de Ramos. He'll certainly be pleased with the way the game's going at the moment. That's Churi Castro, the Uruguayan international. Played 5 times for the Uruguayan national side. Signed in the January transfer window from Real Sociedad. And his first touch, he loses possession, and there's a chance for a break on through Jerome Kiesvetter. The right hand side, he rolls his foot over the ball. And the rather stocky Churi Castro gets the ball, plays it back to Rica. Well, some good work there from Malaga in a tight situation by the touchline, and it's into En-Nesyri. He plays it first time. Fornells, he finds Keco. It's back with Camacho. What has impressed me about Malaga today is their technical skills under pressure when they're really tight with players coming in to challenge them, 2 or 3 players, or very tight to the byline. They've had the ability to maintain control of the ball and find a teammate. Not always a lot coming from it. And Castro was caught a little bit by Cock there. Madeline. Long ball. Zachary Coney out jumps Ngoma. Cock. Fighting for the ball, and it drops kindly for Pablo Fornals. Switches it right to Camacho, to Recchio, back to Camacho, back to Recchio, and then he's looking for the ball out on the right hand side. Rosales, who was initially pushing forward, turned when he didn't think it was going to arrive, but Malaga get possession back, gifted to them from Düsseldorf as Keiko. Rosales, can Keiko get across? Good ball into the 6-yard box, very well read there by Akpaguma. As Fornals was lining up ahead of his own to try and increase the lead to 4-1. So throwing on the left hand side, Federico Rica. The Uruguayan was signed in February from Danubio, a Uruguayan Premier League team. Headed clear by Anderson Lukoki. Everyone apart from the Malaga goalkeeper in the Düsseldorf half, and it's a really excellent ball there through Camacho. Keiko reads it very well, and he crosses, but his cross isn't very good, and it's just cut out easily by Alexander Medlum. He's dwelling on the ball. It's giving Fornals a chance to close him down, but it's coming out now with Lukoki. Some sort of ugly sort of half challenges going in there. I think it was from Recchio. Nowhere near the ball. Camacho said, sort of shrugs his shoulders to say nothing intended there. Well, there you see the first one. That's Recchio. He's just caught the right foot of Sabota. The referee had no alternative but to give a free kick to Düsseldorf as Julian Cock is back to his centre back. Paguma. Space on the left for Anderson Lukoki, the 19-year-old. Oh, he can't keep it in. That's a shame. He's shown a willingness to get up and down that flank since he's come on and replaced Lucas Schmidt. But I think he just took his eye off the ball there. If he had managed to control the ball, he was away on the left-hand side. Whether there would have been an opportunity to get the pass across. We never find out, as we see Friedhelm Funkel with his arms crossed, probably a little bit disappointed at the scoreline. I don't think the performance has been too bad from Dusseldorf. And I don't think the scoreline actually reflects the play, but we have got a chance now of a goal for Dusseldorf. There's a lovely ball sit with the outside of the foot from number 27. Oh, and another great save from Carlos Camini. Well, that was some excellent work by Taylor Duman. He's only been on the field for about 4 or 5 minutes, the young 19-year-old. And he hits a beautiful ball in with his right foot, outside of his right foot into the area. And as the ball comes back, he hits it first time. And an excellent save from Camini. The ball was going to travel way past him and just come underneath the crossbar as it swung in right-footed to the near post. First one to the ball that time was Camacho again. And there's Koch trying to get the ball for the return ball in at the far post. But let's hope we see a replay of that great save there. Number 27, first time he hits it. Taylor Duman, he steers it very well. The goalkeeper reacted instantly. I think Carlos Camini, even though his team were winning 3-1, could be close to getting the honours for man of the match if there was such a thing happening in one of these pre-season friendlies. So about 6 minutes to go in the game now. And oh, we've got a chance here. Another good save from Camini. Oh, there's a follow-up there. Good work there. The break was from Mikey Ngombo. He drew a fine save again from Carlos Camini, but he wasn't able to control the ball from going to a following up player. And I think it was Jerome Kiesvetter who steered it past him into the net. Oh, it's Ozkan Yildirim, number 9. Here's the great break. Good save, but straight out to Yildirim. And the 23-year-old midfield player didn't need a second opportunity there. Hit it first time past the goalkeeper, who was still on the ground having parried out the first one. So it's game on, really. 5 minutes to go here. Can Dusseldorf get the equaliser? Certainly the crowd think there's a chance. They've woken up from their slumber. And they're getting behind their team. Sobotka. Duman nearly scored there. That time, number 15, Rika, climbs all over the back of Kiesvetter. Keiko. That's long ball down the right touchline. For Fornells, well swept by Madlung. Not the best pass, as Cox going to play it, have to play it back to his goalkeeper, Rensing. Well, there's lots of these pre-season friendlies going on at the moment all around Europe. There has been quite a few games of low quality. I've certainly seen one or two myself, but this has been a highly entertaining game for the probably 5,000 or 6,000 people that are now in the stadion here. Now they're scoring first in the first half with a swift equaliser for Dusseldorf. Second half, Malaga scoring again and then stretching their lead to 3, partly from some errors from the Fortuna Dusseldorf defence, but they've fought back to 3-2, and there's certainly still time on the clock, nearly 4 minutes, as Ngombo runs again. Oh, great tackle from Bakri Kone. He would have been much better sliding out to Yildirim on the right-hand side, who had made a run. He was in lots of space there. If he'd found him with the ball and continued his run himself, there would have been a chance for a pass back, and who knows, we might have had the equaliser. Meanwhile, Castro does his impersonation of number 26, who slipped onto the field. I didn't see him come on. Done his impersonation of Dian Swong. So goes to ground there. Well, I'm gonna tell you who it was. It was En-Nesyri. I did see him come on. I didn't realise he was number 26. So yeah. Malaga in no hurry to take this. I think they'll be quite happy to come away with another win. Played a few pre-season matches so far. and they've got a 100% record with wins. They beat Algeciras 4-0 on July 16th. On the 23rd, they beat AS Eupen 3-2. Close game that. Then they went to Cologne, FC Cologne, who are also in Bundesliga 2 this year. They beat them 1-0. They've got a friendly against Almeria at home on the 9th of August. And then on the 19th of August, they start their La Liga campaign with a home fixture against Osasuna. I think it's possible the club might organise a couple more friendlies in between so that they can try a few more players and get their sharpness up. As Sobotka turns neatly there, out to Lukokwi. Arlon Ritter, a little roll over the ball, marked by Koke, but just too heavy that pass forward. Sobotka denies them a chance of a break there, so in the 89th minute, the referee pats the back of Recchio. These players will be getting tired. I mean, they've had some very intensive training sessions over the last 3 or 4 weeks, but it takes a while to get your actual match fitness, and when you're playing a full 90 minutes in the heat, it's not excessive heat, but it's still warm enough. It's not certainly not winter conditions. As Koch plays it back to the two central defenders who make a decision who's going to play it forward. It's going to be goalkeeper Renting, probably back to Koch, but no. This time, Taylor Duman, number 27, plays it back to Renting, launches it long. This could be the last chance of an opportunity for Fortuna Düsseldorf to get forward into the Malaga half as we're into the last minute of normal time. Duman, long cross-field pass to Lukokwi. Can he get it under control? He does very well on his chest. He's running at Keiko. Goes outside, then cuts in. Nice little turn there. Unfortunately, he's drawn a foul. I don't know if he caught Keiko or whether he pulled him back, but Keiko's down sort of, I think he might have got a little knock in an area that us men don't like to be caught. And he's taking his time getting up, and the free kick is awarded by the referee to Malaga. Carlos Camino, you've certainly had an excellent game. Three fine saves in the first half and two brilliant saves in the second half. Unfortunately, one of them cannoned back out to a player who followed it up and scored. But you can't really blame the goalkeeper, as his side have looked like they've won the match 3-1. In fact, as the final whistle from our referee today, Christian Bandurski, is blown. There was a little bit of needle at times in the game, but the two teams are coming together, shaking hands and with the officials. In bright sunshine here at the Paul Jane Stadion in Düsseldorf, our final